Welcome to All Car Review Channel. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you. The longevity of some cars tends to sneak up on you. Case in point, this 2019 Lexus ES. Can you believe you're looking at the 7th generation model? The ES, along with the marque's flagship LS sedan, are the two longest running nameplates in the brand's history, having been on sale since Lexus inception in 1989. In more human terms, that means that the ES family is firmly generation Y, it's a millennial. That may come as a surprise, because throughout its life, the ES has been seen as a conservative, staidly-styled offering. Historically, it's been a model whose appeal was that it was easy to recommend to buyers of a certain age who prioritized qualities like a cushy ride, quiet cabin and drama-free ownership over all other attributes. Riding atop its new GAK chassis, the 2019 model looks set to maintain those hard-won ES family touchstones. After spending a day driving it in Tennessee, I can confirm that it is indeed unerringly serene, and it enjoys excellent ride quality and sound isolation. Further, there's no reason to assume that the new ES will deliver anything other than sterling reliability. But that's what the new model's AARP-friendly likeness is and. Unlike past iterations, the 2019 ES achieves its calm demeanor without resorting to the sort of overly soft suspension that ultimately yields messy handling when pressed. And it does everything wearing a bold new look. Like that famed and much maligned generation of people born between the 80s and the early 90s, the new ES has matured greatly. In fact, the ES and millennials share some commonly associated characteristics. The Lexus is confident, achievement-oriented and possesses a surprisingly strong family drive. As for ascribing another commonly held belief about millennials to the ES, tech savviness, I've got my reservations. Stylistically, the ES started to let its hair down a little in the outgoing generation, but not nearly as completely and dramatically as a car seen here. The 2019 ES is 2.6 inches longer, 0.2 inches lower and 1.8 inches wider than its forebearer, and it sits on a 2-inch longer wheelbase while straddling markedly wider front and rear tracks. The takeaway? The new ES features more athletic and substantial proportions, along with improved cabin range. As before, the ES range comprises both gas, ES350, and hybrid, ES300H, front-wheel drive mid-size sedans. New for 2019 is a third option, the hawkish-looking ES350F Sport. The 2019 ES doesn't just wear a more dynamic and self-assured new jacket, it's got more muscle lurking underneath too. Thanks in part to increased use of high-strength steel, the ES new platform is stiffer. And while the ES shares much of its body in white with the more prosaic 2019 Toyota Avalon, there are a number of key differences, including increased use of laser screw welding and structural adhesives to further improve rigidity. Notably, the ES receives a V-brace mounted behind the rear seats that improves torsional bending resistance at the expense of being able to fold the rear setbacks for added utility. As before, the heart of the ES350 is a naturally aspirated 3.5-liter V6. Thanks to updates that include a revised fuel injection system, output is up meaningfully to 302 horsepower and 267 pound-feet of torque, increases of 34 and 19, respectively. Just as importantly, Lexus has been the outgoing S6-speed automatic in favor of a new 8-speed gearbox with a wider ratio spread for both better acceleration and improved efficiency. Throughout my day's drive in the rolling countryside outside of Nashville, the direct-shift transmission comported itself well, with the exception of being occasionally slowed to downshift, regardless of drive mode, during more enthusiastic driving. Combined, the ES300's burlier engine and smarter transmission yields an estimated 0 to 60 mph time of 6.6 seconds. That's unremarkable, but it's plenty quick for this type of car, and it's a half-second improvement over its predecessor. Estimated fuel economy numbers are somewhat oddly spread out, just 22 miles per gallon in the city, but a much better 33 mpg on the highway, or 26 mpg overall. The ES300H, which features Lexus 4th generation hybrid technology, pairs a 2.5-liter Atkinson cycle 4-cylinder with a more powerful electric motor and a new nickel metal hydride battery pack. Importantly, the latter's more compact dimensions mean that it now fits under the rear seat, saving trunk space. Total system output is quoted at a modest 215 horsepower, plus 15, and a torque figure is not available. Preliminary efficiency estimates call for 43 miles per gallon city, 45 highway and 44 combined. Those are hugely impressive numbers. Toyota says they're enough to make the ES300H the most efficient luxury vehicle offered in the US without a plug. Built exclusively in Kyushu, Japan, most other North American ES models will be built in Georgetown, Kentucky. The hybrid 0-60 mph is listed as a casual sounding 8.1 seconds, the same as last year.